Good afternoon, students. We have already covered CSS, in which we saw how to add color to your page and how to add font family and font size. Now in today's class, we'll be focusing on chapter 5, that is managing the levels of CSS. So firstly, let us discuss the different levels of CSS. CSS, as you all know, is a great tool for adding style to your web pages. It allows you to define the style rules, whereas the HTML is going to have the content of your web page. So this creates a separation between content and design. There are basically three levels of CSS: local styles, page level styles, and external styles. Local styles are basically defined by specifying a style within an HTML elements attribute. That is ki body tag ka jo style hai, wo humne body tag ke andar hi style attribute use karke wahi specify kar diya, usi tag ke saath mein hi. Dusra tarika hai page level styles. The page level styles we have already discussed in the previous two chapters. That is, we have a style tag inside the head section of the HTML page. The third one, which is the most advantageous form of CSS, is the external style. It's wherein we have a separate CSS file and we link that CSS file to the HTML page. So firstly, we'll focus on local styles. Now, local styles are also called element level styles, as it modifies a particular instance of an element on that page. So let us see an example of local styles. You can see the code here. We have a style element in the paragraph tags. That is, you can see inside this first paragraph tag, we have border. And we have specified the border to be 2 em in size. This is the color of the border. This is the style of the border. Similarly, for the second paragraph, we have a different style attribute inside that paragraph tag only, wherein we specify the font family as sans serif, then we use a semicolon. Font size is specified as 1.2 em and then font style is specified as italic. So the style is inside the tags only, inside the particular tags for which we are applying the design. So let us see a couple of things about this code. First thing that we notice is there is no style element in the header. The style attribute is there alongside the tags only. So that is why it is also known as element level style sheet. The second thing is paragraphs have their own style attributes that we already know. The third thing is the entire style code goes in a pair of single quotes. So, एक ही single quote में कोई curly braces नहीं है. Single quotes के अंदर ही style equal to करके सारे attributes specify कराती है. Now, अब local styles कब use करें? Obviously, it's not as good as the page level styles. So, local styles are definitely not our first choice. But they can be useful in some circumstances. Mainly kahan kahan pe use hota hai local style? The first thing where you will notice is the HTML web pages that are translated from word processors. There are certain word processors that allow you to design a web page and you can save them as .html. So when you save them as .html, they convert the word processing elements into HTML elements. And in those particular translations, what we see is that the style sheet is not using page level or using external style sheets. It's normally using local styles. So it's not preferred, but yes, the translation programs use that only. The second place where it is used it is when we are testing how the style will look. Testing purposes ke liye local styles bahut achhe hain. But in production code, we prefer external style sheets or page level style sheets. But the most important advantage of local style sheets is that local styles have very high priority. So anything we apply in a local style overrides the other style rules. Say for instance, मैंने paragraph tag के लिए एक text color already specify कर रखा है. Say all the paragraphs are going to be black in color. But if inside a particular paragraph tag, I override style equal to color red. So that particular paragraph would be now red in color. So these local styles are going to override the page level styles as well as external styles. So if we want to override the defaults, this is a good option. What are the drawbacks of local styles? The first and foremost drawback of local styles is inefficiency. If you define styles at the element level with style attribute, you're defining only the particular instance. If you want to set paragraph colors for whole page this way, this will take a lot of style attributes. So page level style में जो काम सिर्फ एक tag से हो रहा था, अब हमें यहाँ पे multiple tags लग जाएंगे उसके लिए. Multiple times वही चीज़ हर paragraph में repeat करनी पड़ेगी. वहाँ पे हमने एक बारी पैराग्राफ के लिए लिख दिया कलर रेड, सो मतलब सारे पैराग्राफ्स का कलर रेड हो जाएगा. बट क्योंकि लोकल स्टाइल्स में सिर्फ उसी पर्टिकुलर पैराग्राफ के लिए होगा, तो मुझे हर पैराग्राफ के लिए वो स्टाइल टैग रिपीट करना पड़ेगा. सो दे आर हाईली इनएफिशिएंट. द सेकेंड ड्रॉबैक इज रीडेबिलिटी. ऑब्वियसली द कोड इज नाउ नॉट दैट रीडेबल और गुड लुकिंग, सो डिफिकल्ट टू रीड एंड डिफिकल्ट टू मॉडिफाई. हमें पहले ढूंढना पड़ेगा कि क्या चीज़ चेंज करनी है, फिर उसको चेंज करना पड़ेगा. देन वी हैव द लैक ऑफ सेपरेशन. लैक ऑफ सेपरेशन दैट इज नाउ द कोड एंड स्टाइल आर टुगेदर इन द एचटीएमएल पेज. देर इज नो सेपरेशन बिटवीन देम. इन पेज लेवल एंड एक्सटर्नल स्टाइल शीट्स वी हैव अ सेपरेशन. इन पेज लेवल स्टाइल्स वी हैव द स्टाइल सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम द कंटेंट इन द हेड सेक्शन. एंड इन एक्सटर्नल सीएस वी हैव अ different style document altogether. The next is awkwardness. Awkwardness is that the entire batch of CSS rules have to be stuffed into a single HTML attribute with a pair of quotes. This is sometimes very tricky to read and implement, so the developers that are new tend to make mistakes in it. The quote problems, the last drawback is many a times the CSS elements also require quotes and the style attribute itself is to be given inside quotes. So sometimes the user misses the quotes or there are multiple quotes, so it creates an error in my HTML code.